Dearborn. Throughout this campaign, we said that together we can, and together we will bring change. Well, tonight, together, we did it. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all the glory. We plan, He plans, and He is the ultimate of planners. To the young girls and boys who have ever been ridiculed for their faith or ethnicity, to those of you who were ever made to feel that their names were unwelcome, and to our parents and to our elders and to others who are humiliated for their broken English and yet still persisted, today is proof that you are as American as anyone else, and there is a new era in Dearborn. Wife, who never signed up for this journey, but who I could never do this without. I love you. Thank you for being my rock, my moral compass, and the most critically brilliant campaign strategist that existed. And at 9 months pregnant, she still volunteered to work a polling station. To our family, I thank you and I love you. If not for your sacrifices, I would not be on this stage today. And to my team, the volunteers, the fellows, all of you in this room, I am honored to have worked beside you and cannot thank you enough for believing in me. And to my opponent and all the candidates in this race who were brave enough to put their names on this ballot, I thank you for your commitment. And we extend open arms so that we can come together to help move our city forward. I am overwhelmed by the love and support, yet I am humbled in knowing that the hard work is just beginning. I am humbled in knowing that although it was my name on the ballot, today was only made possible by the sacrifices of many who came before me, the giants, many of which are in this room, who had the audacity to dream that this moment could exist.
Amen.
And let us know that while the night marks the first of many, we never ran to be the first. We ran to be the best. 11 months ago, we kicked off this campaign with a purpose: to elevate the issues impacting working people, to be bold enough to present solutions and possibilities, and to reimagine a city government that meets people where they are. Our campaign has been rooted in the fundamentals, talking to residents at their doorsteps about what we can do to improve our collective quality of life. Nearly 100,000 doors knocked, over 150,000 calls made, unprecedented for any election. That deserves a round of applause because it wasn't me, it was us. This campaign helped drive unprecedented turnout for a local election. And to young people who once accounted for only 2% of an election, you turned out, you got involved, and you made the difference.
Yes, you did. Woo!
Tonight's victory marks a new era. Dearborn is the greatest city in the country, but has suffered from complacency for far too long. It's time to deliver a city government worthy of the passion we have for our beloved hometown. We presented thoughtful, innovative solutions to create a healthier, safer, and more prosperous Dearborn that puts working families first. We have plans to lower taxes and provide more efficient services. We have strategies for spurring new development and improving our public health. We're looking to adopt best practices from around the country to create safer roads, to fix our crumbling infrastructure, and to prevent future flooding. Throughout this campaign, we communicated clearly, regularly, and candidly. We put our plans on paper in multiple languages, and we met people where they were so they can provide input. And the people of Dearborn elected us today because we've proven we can deliver in a collaborative, selfless way that unites our city, that puts families first, and that doesn't rely on any special interests. We always believe that if you engage with people, if you talk to them about what really matters, If you actually run for something and not simply run against the other person in the race, you can inspire people to get involved. Years ago, it was my late brother, Al-Marhum Ali, who inspired my first run for public office. He believed that a life dedicated to helping others was a life worth living. He believed that you treat everyone with the principle that everyone is family and you want for them what you want for yourself, and that those you help need not know what you've done, that it's sufficient that God knows. Tonight, as I look across this room, it is all of you who add fuel to that fire and who inspire me to elevate my commitment to the greater good. Dearborn is a special place to all of us. It is our hometown. So tonight, we celebrate the election. But tomorrow we begin the work for the transition. Transition to a Dearborn that recognizes the city's greatest assets are its people. It's each and every single one of you. It's the entrepreneurs that continue to open up small mom and pop shops, and it's in the commitment of institutions like Ford who invest here. The transition to a unified Dearborn, where we no longer allow political, geographical, cultural, religious, or any other division to separate us from being one. It's time for us to focus on what we can do. We need to be bold. We need to rethink our government, and we need to set aside our differences and reinvent ourselves as we rally around a collective vision for our city. To me, that is a Dearborn that puts families first, that shares this prosperity equitably across all corners of our city, and serves as responsible stewards for the generations to come. We can and we will accomplish this together. It is here in Dearborn where we believe if you fight and elevate the voices of the most marginalized, you elevate us all. It is here in Dearborn where we believe that you need not change your name nor your faith. That in this town, we elect you based on the direction in which you lead, no matter the direction in which you tread. And it is here in Dearborn that we believe that no matter what part of town you reside in, our ability to make change comes from our commitment to one another, to roll up our sleeves, throw on those work boots, and march forward, because it is together we can and together we will. For those of you looking to re-energize the city, to start a new era in Dearborn and show the world what the greatest city in the world can accomplish when we work together, I have a message for you. My name is Abdullah Hussein Hamoud, and I am here for you.